Happy Mother's Day, everybody. I want to thank you so much for tuning in today at Muscoot Farm. And we wanted to keep the tradition alive, so we will be shearing our sheep. We do it once a year on Mother's Day. And if you've ever been here before, you probably have seen this guy. This gentleman is Mr. Don Kading, and he has been shearing with us for...
Over 30 years.
Over 30 years, so I wasn't even thought of at that point, because you're so old.
I am.
Okay. So today we're going to be doing some shearing, so hopefully we answer all your questions, but if not, then just leave a comment below in the video, and we'll be sure to answer your question. So we want to introduce you. This is Sprinkles, if you haven't seen any of the videos yet. And Sprinkles doesn't need to get shorn because she was just born this year. So we're going to get started. We're going to put Sprinkles away and then grab our first sheep. And we'll get started.
Sounds good.
Okay. Thanks. Sprinkles' mom. She's Cupcake. So as you can see, she has a big full coat. And you want to come and check this out here?
About 2 inches, 2.5 inches of wool. It took a year to grow, so she wasn't shorn. She was shorn last year, same time at Mother's Day. So she, say goodbye. Say goodbye, wool.
So we do it around this time every year because, as you've noticed, it's starting to get a little bit warmer outside. So once we take this wool off, it'll be nice and cool for the summer, and then they'll grow it back in time for the winter. So check this out.
Bad. Where's the flat machine?
Oh, all is foul. Wait. Thank you so much. So you can see now that this one has been shorn and completely kind of white here. But what we also see is some of this yellow, and that's the lanolin. So you can kind of see how shiny that your hands are. That's the natural oil that keeps the wool from getting wet whenever it rains and the sheep are outside. So we're now gonna put her back in with her baby, and then we'll grab our next sheep. Put this wool into these bags, and then we'll actually have this wool cleaned and then spun into yarn that we use here at the farm for program. So you can see how they really don't fight much whenever Don gets them here, and it's because once you get them on that kind of lower center of gravity there, they comply pretty well with this because they also want this off. As we know, it's getting warmer, so it kind of cools them off.
Thank you.
So, Don, I'm going to ask a question.
Sure.
About how much wool are we getting off of a sheep?
You're getting probably about 6 pounds of wool.
6 pounds of wool.
After you clean it, get the grease off of it, you're going to get probably about 4 pounds, 4.5 pounds of usable wool.
Okay.
Which is just enough to probably to make a sweater. You see, it all comes off in one piece.
Don, what you're not telling the folks out there is that I taught you everything that you know.
Pretty much, yes. You taught me how to get it all off in one piece.
Well, I showed you how to use the glue.
The spray adhesive.
Yeah.
Yes. Yep.
These are all just cheap jokes.
The shoes that I wear are the electric shearing shoes. They send a little charge through the body of the sheep. No, I'm just kidding. It's, if the sheep feels threatened, they're going to kick and try to get away. But if you're relaxed shearing them, then the sheep will be relaxed. So that's the whole idea. If you go in shearing with and stressed out, then you're going to have a rough day. So you have to have a good attitude. So.
And another thing you'll see here that differs from the first sheep that we did, they're both southbound sheep, but what this one's a chocolate variety, the color of wool here. So it doesn't taste like chocolate, but it does look a little brown. So that's our second sheep.
Thank you.
All right, there's another one down. And we're gonna try to put him right over her, right over here. Let's see, have her get back in. And she knows where she's going, so she's gonna let herself right back in the pen there. And you can see they're not traumatized at all. They go right back in with everybody. Okay. Now we are going to get this wool here. And again, you can see it all comes off pretty much in one piece. It's really, really nice and full of lanolin, which is great for your hands and lotions and all kinds of stuff like that. So again, these are South Down sheep that we have here. We have a variety of sheep on the farm, but we're starting today with the South Down. And we'll go over here and meet some of the others. They're getting ready to be shorn. So you can kind of see the before and after here. So we have, again, the chocolate variety here, and these are just the regular South Downs. Now, this is one of the actual breeds that have been on the farm pretty much since its inception. So when Mr. Hopkins had the farm at Muscoot, he did have South Down sheep. And they're what are called typically a dual-purpose breed, which means that they would have been used for wool and or meat. So we'll go back and I'll show you the other ones. And since it's Mother's Day, I'll also show you something else that we have here. So here's some more of the little babies. And then if we look over here, you'll see that these are some of our newest babies from our Toggenburg goats. So we have four babies here, and they were born just about 3 weeks or so ago. So, and I believe our shearer is back. All right. So I think we are gonna go ahead and get another sheep. That's Farmer Shane over there. Doing some wrangling for us.
Does he put the arm in farm?
I don't know that he does. I believe that was me, but wow. Don is stealing hearts today and jokes. I want to just say too, when Don came here, he always asked us how many sheep that we have. And how many that we'll be shearing. And I always tell him to count, but then he tells me that he'll fall asleep if he counts the sheep. So we always have to be careful. That's one of the hazards of this job.
Thank you.
So you can see how clean and ready to go this one is. And gonna go right back in just like so. Now, usually whenever Don's here, we offer haircuts on this day, but since you're all enjoying this from home, unfortunately, we can't do a 2-for-1 special today, but we're gonna go ahead and just clean up just a bit and get ready for the next sheep. You can see how beautiful this wool is. And you can imagine how warm it's kept them throughout this year. And now they'll be nice and cool for when we get all the summer heat. Here comes our next sheep. And you can see how gently they just come down. And once you get them set kind of on their bottom like that, they really just stay put. And the area that he is shearing right there, that's actually called the brisket. And it's the area that sheep don't just jump up whenever they need to get up. So they have to kind of rock on the ground. So that kind of wears as like a callus almost. And so that's what they use to kind of rock to get up off the ground. So that's just a nice little piece of sheep trivia. You can see down there too, you can kind of see in that area. If she had had a lamb, that's the udder area, so you can see the teats there.
Ooh, the lanolin gland.
And that's the lanolin gland right there. That's why you see that darker color, so that's an area where the lanolin comes out.
Yeah.